This was revealed in an engagement between media practitioners and oil companies that included Uganda National Oil Company, UNOC, China Offshore Oil Corporation, Total Energies, and Petroleum Authority of Uganda, among others. According to the spokesperson of SINOC Uganda Limited, Amina Bukenya, they have already compensated over 700 project-affected persons, but they are unable to access the rest of the facilities because they have failed to trace the 1% that is yet to be compensated.
We are only remaining with 1% of the people who are yet to be compensated. That is because we have failed to trace them. But this is affecting the project because we can't fully access the facilities because we have not fully compensated this 1% of the people.
Bukenya has revealed that if they totally fail to locate them, their money will be deposited to court as per the industry best practices and the national regulations.
If we fail to trace them, we shall deposit the money in the Ugandan courts as we wait for them to come and own up, and then that money will be deposited on the different bank account.
She has also given an update on the progress of the Kingfisher Oil project.
I must say, we all know that we had final investment decision announced on 1st February. Then on 11th, we launched the PC contractor, that is Excel. PC1, XL Construction Company Limited. And eventually the contractor mobilized equipment on site and works are ongoing. So it is great progress down there.
The Hoima East City Division Deputy Resident City Commissioner William Donato Kasigazi has called upon media practitioners to also tap into the opportunities that have been brought by the discovery of oil in the region.
In most cases, we love reporting about others. I'm telling you the truth, but we don't think about ourselves. And you feel so good that even if I die poor, after all I gave people information. Yes, thank you so much for information, but the pocket is not good. Are you getting it? So please tap these opportunities. And I know together with these people, we really have a good future for our country.
To register in the National Suppliers Database, so that's when we can easily get some of these opportunities. For example, if you don't get it as an individual, the organization or radio station or company media house that are working with can still get that. And then there is a multiplier effect when the media house gets money.
Some of the media practitioners who have attended this engagement say it is timely because there has been an information gap between the companies and the journalists.
Information gap between this Total oil and gas, SINOC. There are times whereby you find that there is a space between what is taking place on top and to the local people. So for us, we are learning how these companies, they are trying to generate some kind of infrastructure. You see roads, they are making good roads.
The challenge that the oil and gas companies hardly respond to, they delay to respond compared to the editorial timelines. But sometimes you find that you want information as urgent as possible, but for them they have a procedure that they follow inside their organizations.
They have further said that the information given will help them in the way to do their work.
Training conducted by oil and gas sector, and seriously, they have really answered a number of questions which have been personally been asking, and also to that person who is at the grassroots. So the fact is, I'm going to use this information also to educate the person who is at the grassroots who does not know exactly what to do.
Particularly different sectors that they are working on as oil companies, because we have had POW, CIMOC, Total Energies. And I believe with the information they have given us as a journalist, it is going to help us so much to inform the grassroots people.
99% of the project affected persons have been compensated, and currently construction of 56 resettlement homes for compensating the affected primary residents is ongoing in Kangwali sub-county, Chikube district. This report was compiled by Godfrey Mohomuza for the news.